In this training video, we're going to have a look at how you can add your opt-in form code to any third-party site. So what we're going to do is we're going to navigate to the Forms drop-down menu, and then you're going to click on Optins. Now, in this demo account, you can see we've just done one example opt-in. From Optins, you'll click Add New Form, and then Standard Opt-in Form. This will then open up the Templates section, and you'll see third-party form code button at the top. When you click that, you'll see a preview of this, which includes the instructions on how to set up the form. So we'll just click OK, and it's then going to load that into the builder, as we can see here. Now from the builder, you'll be able to read these instructions. Basically, these fields are already mapped for you. All you have to do is hover over the Submit button and then click on the Settings icon. What that's going to do is that's going to load the options field here on the right bar. And what you can do is you can set the action that you want it to take. So when someone submits the form, we're going to want to add a tag. And in this case, we're going to use the tag example tag. You'll be able to use either tags or segments or both to add your contact to opt-in via your new third-party system into Platformly. And they'll be tagged or added to these segments or both. Once you've done this, you can then go and adjust the text on the button as well if you want. Likely, this won't be necessary as you'll be designing these opt-ins in your other provider. And once you're happy with it, you go up to the top left here where it says name this opt-in form, and you'll call it whatever name you're calling it in the other site as well for easy management. So in this case, let's say that I was doing one for SERP.com, which is a blog. I'll just call it SERP.com. And then I'm going to click Save. And that's it. Then you'll see this Get Code button where the Save button used to be. You'll click that, and then you'll see under Option 3, Third-Party Integration. We'll click this one. And then the next thing you do is you're going to choose a API key that you've already set up. And if you haven't set one up yet, you'll be able to click here. It'll load the API keys, new API key. And in this case, what you could do is you could name the service that you're going to use it with. In this example, we're going to use a service called ConvertBox. There we get the key. And here you can restrict IPs if you want. We're not going to do that in this example. And I don't suggest you do that for this specific use case. The good thing is we can then delete these keys at any time if we stop using those providers. Then you're going to go back. And then when you hit refresh, you'll be able to select that key from a dropdown. You see here we have it refreshing. And then we can select it from the dropdown and click Get Code. Now this code here, we're just going to click copy to clipboard, and now it's being copied. So then you go over to your service that you're going to be using. In this case, we're using ConvertBox. And if you are using this one, you're going to look for the custom HTML form and click connect. And it'll be the same in any other service that you use for your landing pages or opt-in forms or anything else. And just to confirm, you also use the same method if you're using it on landing pages for opt-ins, okay? And then we'll just give it a name. So in this case, as I said before, we're probably going to call it SERP.com, and then we click connect. Or in this example, you'd probably call it, yeah, no, that's fine. And you see you can add multiple forms. So this is SERP.com. And then we'll go to the dashboard. And now that that's done, next time we create a campaign, we'll be able to use that, and all the leads that come through there will go into Platformly with the tag that we set. It's as simple as that. We can then close this, and we can then click back. And it says changes may not have been saved, so are you sure you want to leave? We have saved it, so we're fine. And here's the form we created. Now, you can get the form code at any time for any of these by going here and clicking on Edit and then getting the code. You can also click this to unpublish the form and then republish it. And on republish, you can then always choose the third-party integration as well and go through the same process. And it's as simple as that to integrate with any other service that allows you to paste in the HTML as a replacement. Okay, thank you.